You know what? Our own Sam Rubin is around on a Saturday morning. He likes to say that when he isn't breaking entertainment stories, he's changing lives.
Truly, truly. Sam, where's your heart? Where's your head?
Where's your heart? Where's your head?
We're at Manual Arts High School in South Central Los Angeles, just sort of in the shadow almost of the Coliseum behind us. And I came across this. I think it is the neatest thing. Barry Applebaum here is a chemistry teacher at Manual Arts. And we're in the garden, a garden that you helped set up and help flourish. Talk to us about it.
Yeah, so this is our garden where I teach students how to grow their own food with the hope that they'll bring the skills that they learn here to their own families. Manual Arts is in a food desert, so that means it's difficult to access healthy, affordable food. So what we're doing here makes it so that they can have that food at a much easier rate.
And it's an extraordinary thing what you have done from where it started to where it is now. This was almost just sort of nothing, right?
Yeah, we got in here a couple years ago and it was full of weeds and pretty disastrous looking. And it's come to be a space that's really fun and relaxing for my students to be. They enjoy coming out here. They get to spend time in the sun, so it's really nice.
And then today, throughout the course of the morning, something special is happening. From the garden, we're progressing to the whole campus.
Yes, so we are moving onto campus and actually throughout the community. We're planting 40 fruit trees. This is a project by Fallen Fruit, and I'm having Girls Build LA team up with Fallen Fruit to plant 40 fruit trees. And this will help improve long-term food security in the neighborhood and for my students. So I'm really excited about it.
Terrific, Barry. That is really good. And speaking of students, watch this, Chris and Lynette, our pre-selected student. Here's Kenya Ochoyo. Kenya, nice to see you. Barry makes reference to this phrase, food desert. What does that mean?
So to me, food desert means South Central. In South Central, there's more fast food than there's cheap vegetables and fruits here. So us having this community coming here to the garden helps us know where our food is coming from and what we are eating. Also, the trees are giving us an idea of the healthy benefits that it will have for us.
That is the most laudable thing. Gosh, thank you very much. I'll let you keep working. Everyone is referencing these fruit trees and the planting today. David Burns is from a group called Fallen Fruit. It's nice to have you here. Right. And what are you guys providing and what's going to happen here later during the course of the day?
Well, we're partnering with Manual Arts High School. This is the third high school in LA Unified that we've got to work with in the past couple years. And what's so great about this is we're providing fruit trees for the campus, but also reaching out of the campus into the neighborhood along city streets. And what happens in the long run is that these trees provide organic produce for free for everyone to share. So it's not that it's going to last for 3 or 4 years. These fruit trees are going to provide fruit and food to the community for 40, 50, 60 years, which completely changes our city. And the way we experience it, it's really great.
So I'm looking at the label. So yeah. This is an apple tree, this is a plum tree, and as the students are busily working on their things, how long from planting to when do I eat an apricot off of this royal apricot tree?
For a tree to be mature and start bearing fruit is 3 years, for it to be fully productive is 5. So 5 years from now, this is going to be a whole different campus.
And then, and these constantly replace, I mean, and forevermore?
And for decades. For the entire next generation, these trees are going to be healthy and vibrant and changing this community. They're going to be your best friend's neighbor.
Wow. We're going to put something above on the screen there, more information about Fallen Fruit and how you can learn more about what they're doing. What a great idea. Did somebody just sort of come up with the idea?
We started this project in 2004, and we're artists in the neighborhood of Silver Lake. That's where we started, and we started mapping the streets and found dozens and dozens of trees that were ignored. And in that time, we've now planted parks across the Southland, in downtown LA, Culver City, different parts of different communities. What's great about working in communities like this one in Manual Arts is that it is a food desert. It's a place that doesn't get a lot of love. And when we get to work here, it's really special because fruit trees don't really want anything back. They just want to keep giving you something that tastes good.
That's very well said. Chris and Lynette, so when we come back in about an hour's time, all the kids who are working here are going to get together with a bunch of other kids and do what David and Barry described, take all these fruit trees and plant them throughout the campus here and then throughout the neighborhood. And I was just so struck by that phrase, food desert, because we spent so much time on the morning show during the weekend, on the weekend, talking about great places to eat and all that kind of thing. But the fact is, some places are deprived in that regard. And they're certainly trying to do something about that here. So go back to you guys in Hollywood.
It's so fantastic, Sam, to see these young people actually digging in the dirt and planting something and to be able to sit back and watch it grow. What a great lesson in life. That's fantastic.
And I've always loved the thing they do with this. There's thousands of fruit trees everywhere and people don't pick all of it. So they go and pick it for you and make sure that people that could use it. That's just awesome. Thank you, Sam.
Exactly right.
We will
check back with you in an hour and we'll digging accordingly.
We'll look forward to it. He's got to get in there and start digging, doesn't he?
Well, Sam with dirt under the fingernails. I don't know about that.
He just might do it. We'll be right back.
Put some gloves on, that's for sure.